Well, I think the fundamental issue that we in the ANC who are concerned about the need for fundamental change are worried about is that a divided ANC, factionalized ANC, and a corrupt ANC, those things have a relationship with the failure to change society, the failure to build a country of our dreams where millions of people are included, have the means to support life. And the point we are making here is that the ANC needs to understand that internal factional battles will only result in one thing, that we will not have the energy, the necessary organizational focus to improve the quality of life. You know? And the people have the legitimate right to reject an ANC that is divided, that is factionalized, that's not paying attention to their own needs. So anyone in the ANC who thinks that they can play games, they can continue to pursue divisive agendas and factional agendas and think they will benefit from that, they don't know that they are not just undermining a historic mission of the ANC, but they are playing with the lives of millions of South Africans who continue election after election to say that they believe the ANC is the principal agent through which they will realize their dreams. And here in our province, as we start 2020, it's an important decade as we prepare for the National General Council of the ANC, but also as we look at what's happening all over the world, what has happened to some of the most progressive parties destroyed by power and corruption. Some of the best revolutionary parties across the world were destroyed by factionalism. And what they used to stand for, what they used to aspire for, went down the drains because of corruption and factionalism. So we are identifying corruption and factionalism as feeding into the inability to build a country and an economy that meets the needs of all.